see a teen, you'll probably see them on a social media screen. Now the U.S. Senate is asking, is that harming them?
The suicide rate for 10 to 14-year-old has doubled. For young girls, it has quadrupled. Instagram didn't create this crisis, but from the documents provided by the whistleblower, clearly Facebook's own researchers described Instagram itself as a, quote, perfect storm.
The whistleblower giving Instagram's own research to the Wall Street Journal, showing slides with the headlines. 1 in 5 teens say that Instagram makes them feel worse about themselves. Teens who struggle with mental health say Instagram makes it worse. We make body image issues worse for 1 in 3 teen girls. That's their own descriptions and the reason Antigone Davis, the head of global security for Facebook, which owns Instagram, was called to testify.
I want to be clear that this research is not a bombshell. It's not causal research. It's in fact just
directional
research. Well,
I beg to differ with you, Ms. Davis. This research is a bombshell. It is powerful, gripping, riveting evidence.
Disdain for the company was clear across the board.
Have you quantified how many children have taken their own lives because of your products? And number two, as the global head of safety for Facebook, what would you say to a mother, what would you say to a father who lost a child because of Facebook's products?
First of all, Senator Cruz, the research that you are referring to is in fact not causal research.
Critics say Congress can dramatically change how the company operates.
Cracking open the algorithms and saying you can no longer optimize your algorithm for things that hurt people and society. And if they can't make money, if they can't survive in the marketplace with that type of agenda and that focus, then they shouldn't be playing in the marketplace.
And it's going to get more tense for Facebook here on Capitol Hill. Next week, a whistleblower is scheduled to testify, likely fueling a growing desire to regulate social media that seems to be coming from both political parties. Patty Culhane, Al Jazeera, Washington.